This is a problem dealing with internal effectiveness factors and diffusion limitations and porous catalysts. So here we start with very finely ground catalyst particles where we expect that there is very little diffusion limitation and observe a certain reaction rate of 4.0 in arbitrary units. And we use the same mass of particles but in a pelletized form where they're larger in diameter. The reaction rate is 1/4 that of the reaction rate for the small pellets. And so then the question is, for a particle diameter of 1 millimeter, what is the approximate rate for the same catalyst mass? The concept here is that the true rate of reaction, or the intrinsic rate, can be related to the rate that we actually measure, or that we actually operate at, by an internal effectiveness factor. This rate over here on the right-hand side is the actual kinetic rate, that is the rate of reaction at the surface of the catalyst. And this rate on the left-hand side that we would actually observe in our process in an operating reactor is the one that can be lower than the true rate because of slow diffusion, potentially. And that lowering of the rate is taken into account by the effectiveness factor. So for the finely ground catalyst, we observe an effectiveness factor of 1, we expect. And for the 8 millimeter catalyst, the rate goes down by a factor of 4, and so our effectiveness factor is 1/4. All right, and then we're asked about what we expect for a 1 millimeter catalyst. All right, and here we have to utilize the fact that the effectiveness factor can be plotted against the Teeley modulus. And at low values of the Teeley modulus, the effectiveness factor is 1. So somewhere over here is where we measure our effectiveness factor for the finely ground catalyst. Right, and then as we increase the Teeley modulus, then the effectiveness factor will start to decrease pretty rapidly. And it decreases to a value of 0.25 when the Teeley modulus is such that the catalyst diameter is 8 millimeters. Now, the Teeley modulus is proportional for a spherical catalyst particle to the diameter of the particle. And so the Teeley modulus, in going from 8 to 1 millimeter catalyst particles, all right, it's going to change by a factor of 1/8, go down by a factor of 8. All right, and so that's going to push us in this direction. And the Teeley modulus here, we can actually read this off of a plot. So in most textbooks, there is a plot of effectiveness factor versus Teeley modulus. So we can actually read off that the Teeley modulus for a spherical catalyst particle should be 4. All right, that means that it should be 1/2 when we decrease the catalyst diameter to 1 millimeter. All right, again, we go down by a factor of 8. And if you just read off where you are in the plot, you can see on our little schematic here that it shows up as being close to 1. And that is also observed in the case of actually reading that off of a real plot. So if you use that effectiveness factor plot, what you observe is that for that Teeley modulus, the effectiveness factor is very close to 0.9, or maybe even a little bit above that, for a Teeley modulus of 1/2. And so therefore we expect that the rate that we observe is equal to that effectiveness factor times the intrinsic rate of 4.0. All right, and therefore we expect that the measured rate is roughly 3.6 in arbitrary units.